Listen. There's a story in the Bible, right? About when Jesus went to this Pharisee's house. And it was a party. And this, imagine you're a party at your house, right? And you have an important guest like Jesus. And this common prostitute from across the street just come into your house uninvited. What would you do? Right? And Jesus being who Jesus is, not seeing us up who we are to everybody else, right? Not looking at our sins, but looking at our souls, looking at us as his children. Even me with my children, sometimes I don't have time for them. I come home, daddy, I want to play hide and seek. I said, no, I'm busy, I'm doing some work. And I said, go on, have a seat, or get on the phone or something. But Jesus always has time for us, he always does us. And when that woman came in, and she shot to the ground and used her hair and her tears to wash his feet. And the Pharisee was looking at her, right? And then he said, Jesus, you know who you're dealing with? That's a prostitute, right? And Jesus read his mind. He never said it out loud. He read his mind. And he said, look, if you owe somebody $500, and the next man owe the person $10,000, and that debt is forgiven, who do you think is going to be more grateful? The one who owed $500 or the one who owed $10,000? No, $10,000, right? So the person who has more forgiven loves God even more and is more grateful. And that's how I feel. I know I have some people in here who feel the same way, right? Yeah. So this one is called Reckless Love. And it's one of my favorite songs right now. You know, the love of God, even though it says reckless, it's not careless. It's a love that doesn't care about what people think. It doesn't care about the consequences. He laid down his own life for us. giving life to you, loves you.